Hello, everybody. It's the Poltergeist 5000, back more Grand Ace Turn Chronicles. In the last episode, found out that Jailbreak had been poisoned, and our client was the one who hit the poison. And that's not good. Oh my god, what an annoying intro. Can you imagine if that was the first video that somebody ever saw? This was the first video somebody ever saw of mine, and that was the first thing they heard. I hereby call this court to order as you reconvene to continue the trial of Remember Me. Oh yeah, now we get to meet the contrived killer.
Before I address that question, Your Excellency, I have some very important news to share.
Oh? What news? Well, maybe you should wait and see what he's going to say. Why does he look so happy about it?
During the recess, with the collaboration of Professor Mikotoba's laboratory at Yume University, the police re-examined the knife that was used to end Miss Giselle Brett's life.
Excellent. I admire your rapid handling of the matter.
Oh, too kind, Your Excellency. Too kind! I was merely carrying out your instructions, of course.
I had the reagent delivered to police headquarters by rickshaw, so it would be there in good time. But judging by the man's swagger, I fear we might need to brace ourselves for the inevitable.
And, counsel, what were the results?
This dagger, which was so cruelly used to end the life of the victim, has no trace of poison anywhere along its blade.
It's in the pen.
What? Are you sure about that? I would stake the reputation of the police on it.
Armed with the reagent, the test is extremely simple. They couldn't have made a mistake. The murder weapon has been entered into the court. Becker.
Oh, shit, man. In short, the accused's feeble excuse earlier has been utterly destroyed.
Dead. I died. I died to try collide. I guess I stunk.
Oh, man. Man, for a fucking pain. A fucking pain silencing the audience with a desk slam.
Now, the prosecution is ready to call the new witness.
Ah, the newspaper reporter who actually captured... Yeah, we know. Okay, I don't need to read that. Very well, officer, bring in the witness. No trace of poison on the knife. But if that's really the case, then I don't have a case!
How could the toxin have entered the victim's body?
There are deep lacerations in the sternum. Man, look at this dumbass. Witness, please state your name and occupation for the court. Rayton Many Memo of the Show You News. I'm what people like to call a journo.
What's a journo, Father? Do you know? It's simply a contraction of journalist.
I'm where the news breaks, putting pen to paper to catch those scoops so they're in print the next morning.
You didn't do it. It was totally mute. It was totally my dad. My dad told me. My dad. They don't call me the hero of the Herald for nothing. The nice guy of news.
Oh, so, it was you who took this photograph, was it?
Well, well, what have we here?
I'm sorry?
Ooh, brace yourselves, people!
Many Menno senses a scoop in the offing!
Female student up to foul play, defended by curiously handsome young lawyer in Supreme Court. The readers will laugh this up! We'll send it about the fold at 72 point in a 5-length format for the morning edition!
72 point. Huh? But what's your DPI on that newspaper print?
Right then, let's start with your name.
It's Ryutaro Naruhodo.
Next, what made you want to become a lawyer?
I wanted to reform our country's legal system, I suppose.
Ryutaro has suddenly become very ambitious, I see.
I just borrowed Kazuma-sama's dream for a while. Oh, boy.
By the way, my name is Taketsuchi Aouchi.
That's Taketsuchi Aouchi. Aouchi. Oh, it's Aouchi. Okay.
The so-called dark horse of the Supreme Court. My objections strike fear into every defense lawyer's heart.
He didn't ask. I didn't ask, motherfucker.
No, the readers won't buy that. What?
Witness, please state your name and your occupation.
Yes?
What this court demands to know is whether or not you are responsible for the taking of this picture. It was delivered anonymously to the Imperial Police Bureau only yesterday.
Yeah, I wouldn't be a journal if I didn't click quick when presented with a scoop like that now, would I? Sometimes stories call out to me, sometimes I have to chase them down, but either way, you've got to be fast. Fast legs to run with, and fast hand to write with. It's no good if you don't note it down, I always say. That's what I call my mini-memoism.
You have got a fucking hard name to say. Mini-memoism? Yes, I remember your face. We met that day when you were interviewing myself and Soseki-san.
Yes, right. That was me, Mini-Memo again.
But you were supposed to be going back to the Shoyu News offices after our meeting.
But the scoop is, I didn't. Because that Englishwoman's words had piqued my journalistic interest.
Miss Brett's words?
A criminal, left to do as she pleases, just because she happens to be a British citizen? It's horse dung! This country's judiciary is rotten to the core!
The Supreme Court's rulings aren't worth the paper they're written on. The police are just imperial pawns!
Stay your tongue, young man! There are complex political issues at play! Well, anyway, I quickly jolted down those words she said in my mini-memo-memo pad. Are you ready? I'll read it out. It's all here. Right, here goes. I should like to go with everyone to see your country's coast. A serious criminal going on some junket! The people need to know about this! That's why I decided to sneak after them. To get the woman's story, so I could hammer her in the press!
Do you mean to say that you did indeed witness it firsthand? The grim scene portrayed in this photograph?
Oh yes, I saw it with my very own journo eyes. From start to finish, through the viewfinder of my trusty camera.
Good lord. Thank you, Mini-Memo-san. You will now give a formal testimony before the court. You will state exactly what it is that you witnessed of the events surrounding Miss Brett's death. The unknown death, Spilo. And I will attempt to stretch my neck out, because holy fuck.
The beach hut was made of shoddy old reed screens, so there were plenty of gaps I could see inside through. The instrument was sitting on a stool when the student girl came in and started arguing with her. Seconds later, the girl pulled out a knife, throwing the instrument to the floor, she stabbed her in the back.
You wouldn't!
My smoldering journo spirit burst into flames. Quick as a flash, I put up my camera ready to click. I pulled apart the rough weave of one of the screens and poked the lens through for the perfect shot.
Read screens, you say, that you were looking through already?
Right, you can see them clearly enough in that great shot I snapped.
It is a pretty good shot, you know. I'll give you that. You're actually a pretty skilled photographer. The hut walls were just screens made of coarsely woven reeds. Sorry about that. I was writing something down. Yes, it allows the breeze to pass through and bring some relief from the summer heat.
And it was a breeze for me to poke my camera through and see the whole thing hotting up.
Ignoring for the time being the appalling invasion of privacy involved, did you witness everything that happened from the moment the defendant entered the hut?
Oh yes, I saw it. I saw the whole thing from start to finish.
And you say that you took the photograph through a gap in one of the screens.
Luckily for me, they were pretty shoddily woven. I pulled the reeds apart and thrust the lens of my camera through the gap. Would I get away with it, or would I be seen? It was the gamble of a lifetime! A tenacity of purpose that's considered admirable in a journalist, I suppose.
Run a risk one day, run a scoop the next. That's mini-memoism. At last, it would appear we have a genuine witness to this wicked crime. The evidence and testimony are extremely compelling. I believe we may be close to a verdict.
No! Wonderful news, Your Excellency.
Nevertheless, it cannot be denied that this testimony begs one very large question. Oh, I have a message from Tatoilet. Why?
What question?
Exclusive news, a startling photograph, all the makings of an exceptional story for the reporter. Why, then, was the story never published?
Oh, that's right.
It seems clear to me that there are circumstances at play here that are yet to be understood.
Ha! More pathetic excuses!
Okay, whatever. Very well then, Council. Proceed with your cross-examination. Yes, Your Excellency. There's more to this reporter than meets the eye. He's keeping something about this case very close to his chest.
You're hiding something! Spill it!
I was hungry and thirsty!
Hold it. Oh, I don't know. Perhaps because as well as being a proven criminal, the person inside was a young woman.
Ah, I see where you're going with this. Brace yourselves, people! He's painting the journo as a voyeur!
It's hardly slander, sir. You had a camera, and you were taking pictures without the woman's knowledge.
Nope, you've got it all wrong, little student boy.
Sorry.
To my mind, all that was inside that hut was a scoop. Nothing more, nothing less. Scoops know no gender! Man or woman, it's all news! That's not even mini-memoism! It's basic journalism!
If only the courtroom was as indiscriminate.
Right, so if that's all buttoned up, can we move on?
Yeah, I really don't need to. Well, you know what, actually? I do want to know about this, because ostensibly, she was stabbed. Man, what if it turns out that she killed herself? That's gonna be so... I could see that, too. Because I'm thinking that the poison was in the pen. That seems alarming. That seems quite plausible, actually, that she just killed herself. So you actually saw Membami-san entering the hut? Man, Membami and Many Memo. There are so many M's in this case. My God. Raging like my journo spirit.
And the argument you mentioned, what was that about exactly?
You stole it! I didn't steal it!
That kind of thing. Talking about the poison, I suppose. The student girl walked right up to the Englishwoman and really started laying into her.
I mean, if she'd laid into her anymore, there would have been eggs!
The man should have been an author. He's the talents are wasted on journalism.
But the student's rantings fell on deaf ears. Like a Japanese person listening to English for the first time.
He really ought to work on his similes first, though, to be honest. I was gonna say. Anyway, the point is, that woman in the dock was mightily angry. She was good and mad.
And her temper finally got the better of her, it seems. Dear me. Which was the climactic moment that I got on film? It's your pen!
The mark on his arm, the emblem on his arm, it's his pen.
Did we get your first name? I can't present people! Ugh. I can't look at people from this screen.
Hold it!
Yes, okay, your initials are also RM. It's definitely your pen.
You're using a crayon right now. Or a pencil.
The precise... Yeah, he's using a pencil, but he's still dabbing at his tongue. He clearly regularly uses a pen.
I didn't see just that. I saw the whole hellish scene play out from start to finish.
I have here a simple plan of the beach hut. Perhaps you could use it to explain to the court exactly what you witnessed. Right you are. It's all here in my mini-memo-memo pad. And now I'm drawing it on this thing, which is not my memo pad. When I first peered into the hut, I'm sure the Englishwoman was right there. Yeah. Yes, the accused's own testimony confirmed that. Ugh, jeez. The evil student girl! After a while, the pair of them ended up in the middle of the hut, arguing furiously. Went for the student, but the girl dodged out of the way. Whatever. And in a flash, plunged the knife into her adversary's back as the two passed each other. Okay, well, maybe this guy, like, I don't know, if it's, I can't think of a motive here for this guy to have killed her, other than just, like, some, like, nationalist fervor, because he was getting pretty amped up about how despicable he thought it was that she was allowed to go free. But yeah, I don't buy it. Buzz away, Many-Memo-san. Whilst you were watching that terrible scene unfold before your eyes through the gap in the screen, did it not occur to you to try to prevent the tragedy rather than capture it on film? Journos have to be observers. We can't get involved. That's our raison d'etre. So you didn't converse with Miss Brett at all? Obviously not. An observer always remains on the outside looking in. And that's something to be proud of, is it?
Your Excellency, if I may. Yes, Professor? I think the witness's last expertly phrased statement should perhaps be added to his formal testimony.
Father, what are you...
Technically, is he really technically a member of the defense? Nihilism is the foundation of many memoism. What? Okay.
I don't think I have the information I need to pin this guy to the pen yet. I mean, I could explain it, but generally, you kind of want to already have the explanation right there in the evidence you're presenting and, like, have a hint towards it before you present it. Like, I don't want to... I don't know. I've been beaten down so much by modern-age attorneys that having to make an actual logic leap is, like, a foreign concept.
Maybe I did have the wrong impression of you, yes.
Ha! As a culture of story, sometimes I have to be cruel for my art. Yes, that's spot on! Surely he's making all this up.
He claims to have spied the whole affair from start to finish. Yeah, blah, 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 blah.
I mean, the thing is that he definitely had the opportunity to steal the poison, too. Like, he definitely did.
Alright, let me just try presenting the pen. Yeah.
Oh, when I got that statement appended to his testimony, it skipped to the end of the testimony, so I didn't press the middle three, like the last three statements.
The court is fully aware of your desire to capture the incident on film, I'm sure, but why then did you choose to post the photograph anonymously to the police?
Because he knows that the pen connects him to it. I don't think he did it, though. It just doesn't feel right to have introduced this character so late into this case
when he's got, like, he doesn't have that clear of a motive. Like, his only motive is like, ooh, I hate that Englishwoman for being so unfairly be able to walk free. It's, like, bad or something. To boast about.
No doubt your burning desire to see the truth exposed and justice done was what motivated you. That's it. That's brilliant. My burning desire to see something earlier exposed.
There has to be a good reason why he didn't think to write an article about what he saw, though. By your own admission, you are outside. I feel like somebody's trying to pin it on him. Like, I don't think he did it. It just, it's too convenient. I mean, it wouldn't be out of the question for a first case, but again, this wasn't originally going to be the first case. This was going to be, like, the sixth case. So it seems weird that they would have such an obvious, convenient, falls into your lap bad guy. Ha! Obviously not. If they had, where would I be right now? In jail, that's where!
Which you'd think would make you reflect on what you were doing.
No, a journo's job is to collect little snippets of life as unobtrusively as possible. Leave nothing but footprints, take nothing but photos. Yes, that's spot on! Did he just make that up? Isn't that something... Didn't Spark Brushel say something really similar? And this photograph reveals the whole truth. There is nothing more to be said.
Alright. This is your pen, isn't it?
Objection!
Many Memo-san, until now I've had a firm belief that newspapers are in the business of uncovering and publishing the truth.
You're spot on there! The press doesn't lie, which is why I'm proud to wear the emblem of the Show You News on my arm.
In a way, that's more mini-memoism. Sadly, though, it seems the journalists who write for those papers don't always share the same passion for the truth.
What are you suggesting with those recriminatory words, counsel?
Mini-memo-san, do you recognize this fountain pen?
Ah!
This pen was found at the scene of Miss Brett's death. In fact, the murdered victim was gripping it in her hand as she died.
What are you?
See, what I think it's very possible that Eugene Mikitoba is trying to frame. I don't know why I think he's gonna be evil. I just get a vibe. You know, I get a vibe. I'm waiting for them to pull a Turnabout Trump on us. You'll notice that its owner's initials are engraved there. Plus, this guy seems too easy. R.M.
Yes, thank you for bringing that up, counsel. The initials of the accused, Ray Mambami.
Is it a coincidence, I wonder, that your initials are also R.M.?
No!
Writen many memo, R.M.
That's horse dung! Can't you see? One of the central tenets of many memoism is being a pencil user that you tap on your tongue, which makes no sense.
And yet, as the court will clearly be able to see, on your right hand, there is a very obvious blue ink stain.
It would appear that you must have rather carelessly left it somewhere recently.
Your favorite fountain pen, that is.
Horsey horse dung. One horsey!
Many Memo-san, is it not the case that before she died, you met with Giselle Brett in that beach hut?
Why should we listen to this absurd nonsense? It's nothing but another excuse!
Exactly! Show You News will stand behind me all the way! I deny everything! There must be as many people with the initials RM as there are stars in the night sky! The defense has neither the time nor the inclination to count every star in the sky.
Huh?
And there's no need, anyway, because this pen has more to tell. Yes, there is another... That pose looks really silly on you. Yes, there is another clue. A clue that undeniably proves who its owner really is. In that case, counsel to the defense will now show the court where this alleged clue lies. Of course, Your Excellency. Let me examine the... I have to examine the evidence. How do I do that? Mikotoba, can you remind me how to examine the evidence? There.
Got it!
Jeez. Punch! As well as the initials, there is also an emblem on this fountain pen. An emblem that you will, of course, recognize, Minimemo-san. Goodness me! Yeah, this is moving too fast. It's the emblem of the Shoyu News! In other words, the owner of this pen is an employee of the Shoyu... Like, okay. Just pure playtime-wise, we're not even halfway through this case if it's as long as the first case. If it's as long as, the case 1-1. Suddenly, the stars in the night sky don't seem so numerous, do they? Well, Minimemo-san, how do you respond? No! I dropped the pen. I've dropped it. So, this is how the mighty Supreme Court works, is it? Using coercive tactics to have well-meaning citizens reveal harmless secrets. I've used nothing but honest tactics. Alright then, fine. I won't try to hide it anymore. Yes, not long before that grim tragedy unfolded. I, a Shoyu News reporter, on behalf of the public, conducted an interview with the Englishwoman. What? Oh, is that why he was waiting to... Maybe that's why he was waiting to... He was waiting to print the news story. You never mentioned this before! What exactly was this? As I said, it was before that evil little student girl showed her face in the hut. It couldn't have lasted more than 2 or 3 minutes, that's all. It was just a brief exchange. But it came to nothing, and as we many memoists say, the people don't pay their dues for unworthy news. However insignificant you deem it to be, this court cannot overlook the meeting between yourself and the victim. You will testify now under oath about the precise nature of this meeting and what transpired. Got it. Yes, all right. But, on one condition. Condition? In all good conscience, I couldn't speak out alone about this. You need to call back the earlier witness, Soseki Natsume-san. Soseki-san? Oh yes, according to my notes here, that man has a secret of his own! And brace yourselves, because it's not a harmless one. It's big. What? Man, you look ridiculous. Minimemoism states that one man's secret is every other man's front page story.
Very well, I will grant the witness's request in this instance. Officer, summon the earlier witness back to the stand.
So Seki-san, hiding something? Well, I mean, I thought he hid a fair amount before. Oh, he's just there, man. No preamble.
I asked the Englishwoman for an interview, but she declined, so I left the hut without making a fuss. Then, watching secretly from outside, I saw the woman being stabbed and the other witnesses come running. The detective realized that the victim still had a pulse, so he ran off to fetch help. That's when this writer man here asked the woman a very significant question. But he didn't say anything about that in his testimony, which is why Minimemoism demands I reveal it now.
But what was the question?
You mean to say that a victim? I need to scratch my face.
Ah!
I was trying to scratch it with my straw and it wasn't working. The victim regained consciousness?
And when she did, you decided to ask her a question?
That's, true, yes.
He did, and that's not all. The woman gave him a very definite answer. An answer that incriminates the accused. This is preposterous. Why am I only hearing about this now? Why didn't you mention this before, you yokel hack?
It wasn't even a conversation! Yes, I did pose the withering English rose a question. I don't deny it.
but she could no longer speak. She was barely conscious, even.
I put a thorough crossing footage to be conducted.
Yes, I'm going to...
The reporter is claiming that Miss Brett implicated Ray somehow.
What on earth could have happened in that hut? None of the testimony was about that, but okay. Why was that the testimony?
Hold it!
Well, of course I did. I wanted to ask her about the incident she was involved in at the end of last year. About the case in which Dr. John H. Wilson lost his life. That's not the way I phrased it. Many memoism calls for straight talking. Why did you murder Dr. Wilson? Is how I put it to her. Yes, that sort of talking is as straight as a ruler. Ask every question as if you're asking for a menu in a restaurant, I say. It's the best way. A veteran at paper taught me that. And how did Miss Brett answer? With one simple phrase.
Mystery is a woman's charm.
Phew! That told me! So I waltzed right out of there. Really? Something about that doesn't quite seem to fit together. Leave every room as if you're waltzing in a dance hall, I say. It's the best way. A veteran of the paper told me that. Whatever. Watching secretly from outside, I saw the woman being stabbed and the other witnesses coming running.
Hold it!
Not yet. Oh my god, my neck. How many memoists are there? Are there more than you? Ugh, my nose. Ugh. Actually, it's thanks to that photograph that we managed to identify this witness. Ooh, stretch. Ugh. Oh my god. And now that you found me, I'll tell you whatever you want to know. I've got nothing to hide. I'm sure. I'm telling you, I honestly don't know if he does. I absolutely would not be surprised if, I mean, you know, he had the opportunity to steal the poison, but you know who else did? Like, Brett could have stolen, like, we don't know when he lost it. We don't know when the pen left his hand, left his person. Maybe, because Brett was there during the interview, right? So she could have stolen it then. The detective realized that the victim still had a pulse, so he ran off to fetch help. Oh, I should probably. Well, yeah.
Hold it!
What question? What exactly did he say, for fuck's sake? Well, now, you should hear that from the horse's mouth, I think. Don't you, Mr. Writer Man? Out with it, you yokel hack! What did you say to her? What did you say to the dying Englishwoman?
Well, in truth, I'd been catching crabs at the water's edge and building castles in the sand, you see.
Well, the seaside is a place to be at leisure, I suppose, even for a grown man.
But then all of a sudden, from that little beach hut, a young girl's panic-stricken cries for help pierced the air.
Ray.
I ran up the beach to see what was happening, to find the defendant leaning over the collapsed victim. As soon as Inspector Hosonaga saw Miss Brett on the ground, he sprinted off to get help. And then, just a moment later, I heard a faint moan. A moan from the dead Englishwoman.
Wait, okay, hang on. Am I stupid? Was Hosonaga the detective that was escorting her? Yes, okay. Hosonaga was the detective. They keep referring to him as the detective, and I'm like, wait, have we met the detective yet? But no, it's Hosonaga. I nearly jumped out of my skin! What did you ask her?
I asked her, who did this to you?
Don't protect us any longer! How did the woman respond?
She didn't! She said nothing in response! But...
when in the stand, you will answer the questions asked of you unambiguously. Now, without invasion or reticence, I demand that you amend your testimony.
I will! I will! I asked her who did this to you, but she never replied.
Okay, there was a butt there, you asshole!
He who asks a question is a fool for a minute. He who does not remains a fool forever. And having been labeled a criminal twice during my time in Great Britain, I was quick to make up my mind. Better to be a fool for a minute than remain a fool in prison forever!
However, you've indicated that the victim failed to respond. Is that correct?
I know why. I know why the influence had nothing. She was ignoring me! Because of my stupid mustache! Because I'm Japanese!
Oh dear. Sasaki-san has really developed a dislike for the English, it seems. Having read the report on this time as I'm in Great Britain, I can't say I'm surprised at his xenophobia.
But the influence didn't ignore you at all, did she, Mr. Writer-Man?
Well, yes, alright. She did respond in a manner of speaking, I suppose.
She said, "You're a goner."
She just lifted a trembling finger and pointed it in the direction of the defendant.
Hold it!
Miss Brett pointed a finger at the defendant?
So, Seki-san, is that really true?
It's not easy to stand here and say this, but...
Oops.
Don't open your OBS settings, you dumb. It's a good thing I didn't just accidentally click stop recording.
When we first entered the beach hut.
Is this the voice I gave him before? I think that's...
Ingram was sprawled on the floor before us with the student girl standing on the far side of her. And when I asked, who did this to you? The Englishwoman summoned her last ounce of strength to point a trembling finger at the back of the hut.
Which was, it can't be denied, in the direction of the student girl who stands accused today.
No!
So, Seki-san, why on earth did you neglect to mention this in your original testimony?
But, fiddlesticks, I say!
This is not a British court of law. You will respond in Japanese.
Did he just say that in Japanese? I guess it was in quotes.
But I was trembling, and she was trembling, and everything was a blur. And thinking about it, I feel as though perhaps she was pointing in a slightly different direction. Actually, no! Not slightly! In a very different direction to where the student girl was standing! To somewhere at the back of the hut, where nobody was standing at all!
You mean that your memory of events and the direction in which the victim was pointing are both unclear?
Yes, that's it! Unclear! I'm very, very unclear!
Your Excellency, surely this proves the matter beyond all reasonable doubt. Yes, the woman may barely have been conscious, and yes, perhaps her finger wavered slightly, but there can be no doubt that this was an attempt by the victim to confirm the identity of her assailant. Why? Because, as the court can see, there was no one other than the accused and the victim in the direction the victim was pointing.
Well, okay, I need to figure out, okay, where did... Where was Minimemo pointing his camera in from? Because in the photo, it looks like it's like diagonal. No, it's definitely right from the back.
It is now abundantly clear that no one besides the accused could possibly have committed this crime.
It wouldn't be a cool enough conclusion to the case for it to have been this guy. This dumbass.
Kamoshida, that's his name. I'm inclined to agree. And in the absence of any credible argument to the contrary, I believe we can now conclude this trial.
No!
No!
The headline's writing itself. Dashing lawyer's hopes dashed. 92 point across the whole page. We'll do an extra edition.
This is a serious blow, Susato. Unless we're able to identify the true culprit and substantiate our claim with evidence, the judge will give his ruling and the trial will be over.
What about the pen? We still don't know why she was holding the pen. We need to know why she was holding the pen. We never actually got a straight answer.
You know, I never looked at this knife.
Fastidious about cleanliness, haven't you?
I think this is something else, Father.
Man, nothing else here? Nothing else to examine. Alright.
The label appears to be written in a foreign language that I don't know.
It's German, so your knowledge of English is going to be of little help here, I'm afraid.
Couldn't you just have written medicine on it in Japanese? Then we'd all be able to read it.
German is the international language of medicine, my dear. But yes, I can certainly see the merit in labeling the bottle in Japanese. Though I'm not sure medicine would be entirely appropriate.
I mean, yeah, I can...
See, what confuses me is that how did she raise... Like, how could she possibly have pointed so clear in a clear direction when she was facing... When she collapsed facing towards the door out, like, the complete opposite direction?
I'm gonna be honest, dude, Mr. Reporter Man, your window of opportunity is closing here. The only thing saving you at this point is the assumption I have that we still have 2 hours left in this, but I know how they can drag this shit out, so I don't know if that's gonna save you. I'm also trying to remember, like, how this case ranked, because I don't think if it was this guy, I don't think it would have ranked that high, you know? Just let me present some fucking evidence! Oh my god! Ugh! I know how!
Okay, yeah, whatever.
Your Excellency, I respectfully ask you to postpone your adjudication for the time being. To what end, counsel? So I can present some evidence. The defense would like to present the court with an alternative theory. An alternative theory that can explain who the victim was actually trying to implicate with her dying gesture. An alternative theory? Ha! None exists. Stop waffling! Let me get to the point! Oh my god! What?
And the victim, Miss Brett, tried to reveal who it was to those around her at the time. By mustering all her remaining strength and pointing a trembling finger in the killer's direction.
This is fiction! Fantasy!
Very well. As you seem so sure of yourself, counsel, I am prepared to hear your alternative theory. So, young Ryutaro Naruhodo.
Yes, Your Excellency. You will present your latest theory to the court by means of this plan.
Where exactly are you proposing the culprit was concealed? They were outside.
Take that!
Naruhodo-san would never give up. And I'm a Naruhodo now. I'm a Naruhodo. The Turk over to finally establish bread.
was concealed in this location here. Are you mad, Council? You're suggesting the culprit was outside the hut!
What?!
Well, he's sure sweating. But the thing is, even if he wasn't the killer, of course he would be sweating right now. Who wouldn't be sweating if they could tell that the conversation was going in this direction? It's not like you'd just be totally cool as a cucumber just because you know that you're innocent. You
just pointed out the exact spot where I was hiding to get my scoop snap.
But I didn't see any suspicious individual loitering about. I can swear.
Yeah, there's no way that you killed her. There's just no way. Unless you have like a split personality. Obviously, if the culprit had been outside the hut, there is no way that he or she could have stabbed the victim who was inside the hut. Come on, guys. This motherfucker stuck a camera through there. You don't think a knife would fit?
Man, if this were Ace Attorney 1, Phoenix would have just said that. Phoenix would have just said that. He would have said, Many Memos done stuck a camera through that wall. You think a knife wouldn't have fit? And that would have been the end of the conversation. We would have moved on.
You're bluffing! You're bluffing! You're bluffing, you yuckle! You luckle!
Take that! Is it that or is it the other thing? Okay, the original chronographic print of the crime scene? Yes, it's clearly visible in this print. The trace of the fatal thrust that was delivered from outside the beach hut.
Do you take us for fools? There's no hint of any such thing!
I'm not sure that everyone present would agree. Someone, at least, appears to have noticed what it is that I'm referring to.
Yeah, I don't think he did it. I think he showed up. I think he's just lying about how he saw the whole thing because he wants to get the scoop. But he didn't actually. I think he got there later. He probably saw the slit in the wall, and was curious because of that.
Take that.
Look closely, just here. In the screen at the back of the hut, you can see the effects of a blade having been forced through the reeds.
No, I can't! I can't see any such thing!
It's true that the hut in question had four walls, as you'd expect. However, by parting the reeds, a knife blade could easily penetrate them.
This is extraordinary!
Yes. The true culprit actually stabbed the victim from outside the beach hut. And of everyone present at the scene, there is only one person who could have done that. Only one person who was directly outside the hut when Miss Brett was killed.
Right, Minnie Memo-san, it could only have been you!
I'm telling you.
There ain't no way. Are we to assume, as part of this farcical scenario, that they said it was a knife thrower?
No, of course not.
We're not?
If you recall the testimony of the defendant about the events just before the victim's death... Inside the beach hut, I confronted Miss Brett. We have to listen to the entire thing!
A stool...
Have another look at the photograph. The slit in the reed screen
would align perfectly with the back of a person who was sitting on that. That's a really high-res photograph. My word! So, in fact, the victim was
killed whilst sitting on that stool
by a stab wound to her back delivered through the reed screen.
Having been attacked, Miss Brett rose to her feet instinctively. But then, unable to speak, she collapsed on the floor in the middle of the hut. Before the defendant, Membami-san's appalled eyes. And that, Your Excellency, is the truth of what happened on the beach that day.
by your silence, Minimemo-san.
I take it that you don't deny the charge. I'm sorry about that he's being threatened by someone.
This is absurd!
Yeah, you're telling me. Man, he's been frozen in that pose for like 5 minutes now.
That will do!
You tell that asshole.
It would appear that we have a tacit admission of guilt from the witness. Accordingly, this court has successfully established the truth of this matter. Which means that the defendant, Membami-san, is innocent of the crime.
I finally made him cave! Well, so happy. I must say, I've never been more proud.
Yeah, this guy was totally set up. This guy was totally set up.
What of my growth? My growth of hope! It wasn't all aberration! I can't accept this! I won't!
I see no reason for the continuance of this trial. I will therefore move to conclude proceedings by delivering my final verdict and... Yeah, here he goes.
Shock! Shocking!
Oh my god!
Well, this is all very convenient. This is how the highest court in our mighty empire delivers justice, is it? Suppressing well-meaning citizens' freedom to speak and branding them as criminals?
I mean, you definitely have a beef with the justice system, so I could see someone setting you up to be the fall guy. Or even see you being so angry with Brett that you might do this.
But we've established that the victim was stabbed from outside the hut through the reed screen walls.
And no one but you was in place at the time to have this hand on the hilt of the blade.
It's a perfectly logical deduction.
So, your argument hinges on the location of whoever stabbed the Englishwoman, does it?
Well, it seems a little irrelevant now.
What?
Irrelevant? Where she was stabbed, how she was stabbed, it doesn't matter. I mean, whether she was stabbed at all makes no difference if you think about it. After all...
This trial has already shown the whole thing hinges on something else. What the hell are you talking about? Also, new pose. Scary. What the hell are you talking about?
Brace yourself, little man. I'm talking about the fact that everything's changed. Because of the dirt you dug up!
What? Enough obscurity! Explain yourself, witness!
What's to explain? I'm talking about the poison, of course.
The poison?
Yeah, because it would have had to have been a few minutes before she died. Whoever stabbed her a few minutes before she died. So,
let's ask the professor for a comment on the situation, shall we?
I understand that a deadly poison you were developing was stolen from your laboratory, correct? And it's been shown that this poison was administered to the victim, Miss Brett. Is that right?
That is correct. The unusual constriction of the victim's pupils are a sure sign that this particular poison was used.
I see. Right, this didn't come up at all because it was proven that the knife wasn't tipped with poison.
So presumably that means that the victim already had the poison in her body before she was stabbed?
Maybe. Given that her pupils were clearly constricted, it seems highly likely, yes. If she'd been dead already, the poison could not have circulated in her blood.
I mean, it's not like she was going to die instantly from a stab to the back. Unless maybe she went into shock.
Ah, how refreshing to hear the argument of a metropolitan mind.
Precisely! It matters not a jot who stabbed whom and whose back and with whose blade. Because, quite simply, the Englishwoman's life was taken not by the knife, but by the poison! But that can be explained by the poison being on the blade, as I already...
No, we already deconfirmed that.
Forgotten already, have we?
I almost had.
During these very proceedings, the laboratory of the professor at your side assisted in proving that the blade of the weapon used to attack the victim had no trace of the poison on it whatsoever.
Ugh. It was on the pen.
So let me get this down. The facts is skillfully established by the defense in this trial turn out to be a headline-making red herring. Is that about right? Well...
Ugh.
So are we going to spend another hour circling back around to the pen, or are we going to figure out the pen, like, right away and then move on to, you know, is that going to be a red herring too? Like, I don't know. You mean she drank it? Have another look at the photograph here. As you can see, a bottle of carbonated water and a glass had been knocked onto the sandy floor of the beach hut. The poison could have been slipped into either. So somebody made Miss Brett drink it. Well, what do you know? Look at those dashing eyes. This will make a great front page shot. Hey, why the bewitching stare? After all, I'm the last person you should be looking at. It would make no sense at all if I had poisoned the worm with a woman, would it? I mean, that's been established already. Established? What are you talking about? Hmm? Don't tell me you've forgotten. That's a little hard to believe, given that the person who established it was you! Me? What on earth does he mean? Ooh, let me recapture those wide eyes. This is prime press fodder, this is. It would seem that this trial is not destined to end yet, after all. I hereby call upon the witness to give further testimony, which we will hear next time on the Great Ace Attorney Chronicles. Oh my god, my throat hurts a bit. I want to keep going, but my... It's my fucking nose. It's my fucking doze, man. My stupid doze. Alright. It's a bit of an awkward place to end. Well, you know what? Let's get to the testimony. That's great, that is. Let me get a shot of that magnificent beard, Your Excellency. It would be impossible that you were the one responsible for administering the poison to the victim. It was this according to your testimony. What would make such a claim? Yeah. I thought I'd illuminated the truth, but it slipped right back into obscurity again. Just where is this trial going to take us? Find out next time on the Great Ace Attorney Chronicles. Resolve. Bye, guys.